All right. We got some interesting stuff to talk about here about Zelda. That's right, The Legend of Zelda, because E3 is coming up, and we got some kind of rumors floating out there about what's going to be at E3, specifically in regards to The Legend of Zelda. Potentially some other games, we'll get into that for a bit. But first, it looks like we're actually going to hear about something from Zelda coming up in the next few weeks. Now, this originally sort of came out from the E3 rumor batch we did from Samus Hunter, but since then we've had some reconfirmation on about a time period we can expect the Zelda announcement to come, and some ideas of what that announcement might be. Could just be Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity DLC information, as some of you guys have speculated, but Samus Hunter actually kind of teased something to me that potentially could be what we're going to see. Let's just say there's a chance we might see Breath of the Wild 2, a little teaser bit before E3, and a massive chance that E3 itself is going to contain a huge Breath of the Wild 2 blowout. Now, first let's get into the stuff. So this guy named Shreyas was talking on Twitter and responded to Samus Hunter on one of their recent tweets showing off some how they got some Monster Hunter information correct. And it says, so what exactly are we getting on May 6th? Or is it still unknown? And you said there will be something around May 21st from Nintendo. Any chance it's Zelda related? Thank you. Samus Hunter responds and says, around May 6th, I don't know the exact date, if that is like a public reveal date or if that's just an internal staff date. Nintendo will release official statements for their E3 plans. So either on 6th, all the employees at Nintendo will know what the E3 plans are, or it'll just be announced to the public. They're not really sure. Either way, we found out on May 9th back in 2019. So yeah, I would say somewhere in the first 10 days of May, we're going to publicly find out anyways. And said, and yes, the second date is for Zelda-related stuff. So, okay, yeah, so May 21st, Zelda-related stuff. So I DM'd Samus Hunter and said, hey, so for that Zelda thing on the 21st, is it just an update on the Age of Calamity DLC release, or is it something else? I know First Four Figures plans to unveil more champion figures and such, but you know what I mean. Is it related to other games? Don't have to tell me what games. I'm working on a video, so I don't want to mislead people. And he says, Samus Hunter responded to me and said, that is the maximum date for its announcement. Most likely it will be even earlier. So what he's saying is sometime basically in early May to the 21st. It will not go past May 21st. We're going to hear something about Zelda. And he says, at the moment, I do not have precise details. As I often say, Nintendo is very secretive about things concerning Zelda. But I would say the DLC for Hyrule Warriors could safely fall among those announcements. He's like, I don't expect a major new reveal. So, you know, he's not expecting a game, although that he doesn't really know. But it's possible they could tease that we are going to get more information of a sequel of Breath of the Wild E3. So, like, when their E3 plans get unveiled, there could be a tease that, hey, this E3, Breath of the Wild 2, baby. Which is exactly what they did back at E3 2016. We knew ahead of time, Breath of the Wild. So that could be what he's talking about. It could just be a teaser for that. Now, this is where things get really, really interesting. Because someone noticed an old 4chan post. Now, typically, we don't talk about 4chan rumors unless we're just laughing at it, or we just think it's a really interesting idea, but we don't give it any credence. But the weird thing about these 4chan rumors is kind of like Samus Hunter, everything seems to be checking off the further and further we get into the year. This post came up at like the very beginning of 2021. And here is essentially what this 4chan post said, and we can just literally start checking off things that were right on this post. It could just be guesses, but it's pretty accurate guessing. So it says, 2021 will have a bunch of anniversaries, no particular reveal order, and some might be early 2022. So he's saying we're going to see a bunch of stuff, but he's not going to tell us the order these games are coming out. This is just, you know, in general what Nintendo is going to talk about this year. Mario Kart 9, okay, haven't heard anything about that yet. Mario Golf, hey, we got Mario Golf announced, Mario Golf Super Rush by Camelot. A Breath of the Wild sequel, getting a full reveal and planned release this year. That would obviously be E3 blowout time. Skyward Sword HD, already announced. Diamond and Pearl remakes, already announced. Pokemon Snap, obviously. 2D Metroid, which is supposedly coming, I don't know, maybe this summer, by Mercury Steam. and Metroid Prime Trilogy. He said, we're also going to see a new Kirby game, a retail release version game, not just like a digital game. Famicom Detective Series, which we already have that confirmed. New Fire Emblem Echo style game, so like a new Fire Emblem remake. Grezzo has a Zelda title planned to come out this year. We've talked about this in the past, about how that the Grezzo very, very likely has some sort of remake or something for Zelda this year. Ninja Gaiden Sigma Trilogy is coming to Switch very soon. Dark Souls 2 is getting ported to Switch. We've had recent rumors about that. Also, Smash apparently has Ryu Hayabusa is somewhere in this wave of the final Smash characters. So basically, the final two Smash characters will be Ryu Hayabusa, according to this person, and there'll be additional fighters confirmed to be in development. So what he's saying is there's going to be a third wave. A third wave of Smash characters. So they're not done, according to this person. And there'll be a fighter from Sega's Phantasy Star series is planned, seemingly being Phantasy Star Online 2's Matoy. Now, again, there's some more information in there beyond Zelda, but the point is that a bunch of that stuff seems to be checking off. And so when that happens, we can't just ignore that that exists. So there's potentially a bunch of information there. Now, it's kind of weird because Samus Hunter, who I've been giving a lot of credit to because literally they've never gotten anything wrong, did put out there, at least to me, that they don't think Mario Kart 9 is even like even a thing this year. They feel like they would have saw something about it by now. But again, this person says that some of these could be 2022. Could Mario Kart 9 be something that's talked about at the end of this year and releases in 2022? And thus Samus Hunter wouldn't know because Samus Hunter, I don't want to give away exactly how Samus Hunter gets their information, but let's just say they wouldn't be privy to the information based on the method they get that information this early if it's not going to be announced till later this year. But still, I think it's pretty crazy. I think it's really, really cool. Zelda, baby. Breath of the Wild Blowout? Breath of the Wild 2, Blowout, baby! And could we get a small tease, some new official art? Even new official art would be crazy. I'd be, oh my gosh. I'm like tingling just at the idea. I had to put on a Zelda shirt. I know it's not a Breath of the Wild shirt or whatever. I wear the Breath of the Wild blue shirt all the time from E3 because I got like 12 of those damn things because I played the demo so many times back in 2016. But baby, oh, am I pumped. Am I pumped. This is some of the most exciting stuff to ever happen, as I know my TV went kind of blank over here. It's actually a Splatoon background, but it doesn't fit the resolution of this TV. It is what it is. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. This has been a lot of I'm excited. Sure to enter our giveaway. We're giving away $100 cash money. Still a handful of days to enter. Head down to the description of the pinned comment to find out how to enter. Otherwise, tune into our E3 coverage. We'll have a link to our very first E3 2021 stream happening on June 12th, so you can go set a reminder for that. That's right. We already have that stream set up, although we're still building out the things that are going to be on that stream. Still, tune in, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.